Well, guys, happy May the 4th. How are you guys doing?
Hold on a second. I gotta do this. Phew. I got a lightsaber, bro.
Check that shit out. I got three of them, actually. One's custom made. This one's getting a little old, though. But, guys, what's the perfect Star Wars movie? It's not even called Star Wars. It's called Spaceballs. I don't know how I've never watched this, knowing I'm a huge fan of Mel Brooks' work. Blazing Saddles. Can't think of any off the top of my head. Shit. Well, anyway, he created this movie called Spaceballs. I've never seen it. I just watched it yesterday, and how the hell did I not see this movie beforehand? This movie is one of the funniest movies I've ever seen, guys. Oh my god. Oh shit. Woo! Mel Brooks just always gets me, man. He knows how to hit those. It's so fucking stupid. So, Spaceballs is a parody of Star Wars. And I thought on May the 4th, which is today, I would do that. Just review the movie. So, let's get into it. So, Rick Moranis plays like this version of Darth Vader, but called Dark Helmet. And the jokes they make in this movie, like, it's so... It's not just also knocking off of Star Wars. It's I can see, like, a little bit of Star Trek in there. Any space movie, Spaceballs gotcha. Because, oh, the song is catchy, too. We're the Spaceballs! It's so stupid, but it's awesome. So, a lot of action. Every single one of these cast members I loved in this movie. John Candy, rest in peace, man, did amazing as a version of Chewbacca, which is also named Barf. Great inclusion. Rick Moranis plays Dark Helmet, though. He's probably got to be the funniest character I've had in this whole movie. So, he literally make like a joke where he looks up at someone, I can't breathe in this thing. Oh, fuck. Anyway, I'm not going to be reviewing this movie because I don't want to spoil too much, but I'm going to be naming the funny moments that I absolutely just lost it at. Now, these troopers, like stormtroopers, but they have like little balls on their head. That's pretty fucking funny, if you ask me. They're combing the desert in one part. And I don't know how this shit got... Well, I guess it was like 1980. When did this movie come out? 87? So I guess they can make jokes like this, but I love it how like all the white fucking... all the white stormtroopers, I'm gonna call them, because I don't know what to call them else. They're all combing the desert trying to figure out if there's any... I don't remember what they're trying to find, but they're all combing the desert. And the white guys have regular combs. And then the fucking two black guys have a fucking pick. And they go, hey, have you guys found anything? We ain't found shit! And it's just... oh my god, it's so bad. Like, I can see a black person laughing at that joke. Depending on who they are, because it is a little bit racist. Oh man, this movie. Mel Brooks, I feel like with every single one of his movies, is just... I'm surprised half of the humor he has actually gets past the boardroom. Yeah, this movie was batshit insane. I loved it, and I can't believe I've never watched this movie before. It's a great parody of Star Wars. It's very stupid humor, which I absolutely love. There's like so many little moments that you can enjoy in this movie, and it's just fun overall. So guys, that's pretty much my review for it. I'll give it a golden TV. I'm gonna give it a 26%. This movie's awesome, guys. Actually, it is better than The Force Awakens, The Last Jedi, and The Rise of Skywalker combined. You cannot convince me otherwise. This movie is an absolute classic, and I'm glad I got the chance to witness it. So tell me what you guys think about this movie in the comments down below. I might be doing a Star Wars Funko Pop live stream later, I don't know. But if you guys aren't familiar with my other channel where I post my puppet movies and stuff like that, there's Shark Slayer Universe. And I will be releasing the Shark Wars Dark Days Part 2. trailer. So look out for that. Anyway, guys, that's it. Peace. And happy May the 4th.
And remember,
may the Schwartz be with you.